It was late tonight. The Berklee College Republicans threatened legal action against the university. The ultimatum: honor the original terms of the speech by tomorrow, or they're taking their case to federal court. KPIX 5's Kristen Ayers is at the Cal campus tonight.
First, officials here at Cal Berkeley told students there would be no speech by Ann Coulter. Then this afternoon, an about face.
Today, Chancellor Nicholas Dirks changed his tune. Conservative pundit Ann Coulter can come to UC Berkeley's campus, but not on April 27, and not at the original location. Dirks called the new location
an appropriate, protectable venue that is available on the afternoon of May 2nd.
Campus Police Captain Alex Yao says police simply could not guarantee that Coulter's originally planned speech would be safe.
There's very specific, incredible threat to Ms. Coulter's event on the 27th if it were to be held on the Berkeley campus.
Authorities could provide more protection at the new venue in hopes of avoiding scenes like this. An outright riot that ensued when ultra-conservative writer Milo Yiannopoulos came to campus in February. Since then, two other free speech protests have turned bloody in downtown Berkeley. Hours after Dirks proposed the date and venue change, Coulter unleashed a tweet storm. "I'm speaking at Berkeley on April 27th as I was invited to do and have a contract to do," she tweeted. "We've already spent money for 427 Berkeley space and I can't do May 2nd. There are no classes at Berkeley the week of May 2nd. She also claimed the campus added new, more burdensome conditions on my constitutional rights, though she didn't say how.
And we're going to protest it, whether it be the 27th or the 2nd or whichever day she comes.
Tonight, we've learned by any means necessary, the far-left group involved in organizing the Milo protest and the counter-protest that followed intends to protest again and is putting no limits on how.
As long as these right-wing Trump people insist on coming, we're going to confront them, we're going to protest them, we're going to make it clear that they are not wanted and it is not acceptable to harass and intimidate, to attack.
The Berklee College Republicans are not taking this lying down. Their lawyer just sent out a statement to the university. It says in part, "If UC Berkeley continues to insist on violating the constitutional rights of its students and our clients by marginalizing or banning Ms. Coulter's speech, we will seek relief in federal court." UC Berkeley officials have not yet responded to that statement. In Berkeley, Kristen Ayers, KPIX 5.